Hello everyone, myself Kiran Kadkumkla, lecturer, Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. Today, in this session, we are going to discuss about Zener diode as a voltage regulator. Okay. So before starting this, we'll revise the topics covered in the previous class. In the previous class, we discussed about the regulator. So we understood what is meant by regulator, what is the need of regulator. Then in the regulator, we understood what is line regulation, load regulation. Okay, so in the line regulation, after the line regulation and load regulation, we understood about the types of regulator. So regulators are mainly classified into two types, that is a linear regulators and switching regulators. In the linear regulator, once again we have two types. Okay, one that is a series linear regulator, one is a shunt linear regulator, and then we have class we have one more classification, that is a switching regulator. In switching regulator, we have a three types. One is a buck switching regulator, one more is a boost switching regulator, one more is a buck boost switching regulator. Okay, so in a linear regulator, we'll be using the active pass element, that is a transistor will be using as active pass element. In the linear regulator, we have two types, that is a series and shunt linear regulator. In series linear regulator, we are using the active pass element in series with a load, so it is called as a series linear regulator. And in shunt linear regulator, the active pass element transistor is connected across the or parallel to the load, so it is called as a shunt linear regulator. So this is what we discussed in the previous class about the linear regulator. Then we discussed about the switching regulator. In this, it will transform the output voltage to the pulsed waveform, then it will be smoothened. Okay, so that is the switching regulator. In that, once again, we have discussed about the three types. One is a boost switching regulator. Boost means it will step up or increase the voltage. Let's say example, if we have a 10 volt and we need a 12 volt, so then we can use the boost switching regulator. Then we have discussed about the buck regulator. Buck regulator means it's the stepping down or reducing. Say example, we have a 15 volts and we need a 10 volt. Okay, so we have to down convert it. In that case, we use a buck switching regulator. Okay, so that is a one more type of a switching regulator. The third type in that is buck boost switching regulator. So it's a combination of both, like buck and boost. It is have a option of increasing the voltage or even it is a decreasing the voltage. Let's say example, we need output voltage 12 volt. We have a 10 volts. Okay, then it will increase from 10 to 12 volt. Even it has an option to reduce. Suppose say we need a 12 volt and the available voltage is 15 volt, it will reduce the voltage. So output will be constant irrespective of the changes in the input voltage. So that is the buck boost switching regulator. So these are the topics covered in the previous class, and we have discussed some problems based on those topics. So those are the topics we covered in the previous class. In this class, we are going to learn about the Zener diode as a voltage regulator. So here we are dealing with the voltage regulator using the Zener diode. So before going to this circuit and its explanation, we'll discuss about the Zener diode. In the previous semester, we already learned about Zener diode. Okay. So do you know or do you remember what is the major difference between the Zener diode and the normal diode? So what are the main characteristics differences of Zener diode with respect to the normal diode? Okay, in a normal diode, so Zener diode is similar to a normal diode during the forward bias. Okay, in the forward bias characteristics, you won't have any differences between the Zener diode and the normal diode. Both will be having the same operations. But when it comes to reverse bias, so Zener diode will be having the sharp breakdown region. Okay, it will be having the sharp breakdown. That is the major advantage of Zener diode over the normal diode. This Zener diode has that sharp breakdown because of its heavily doped. Okay, so we won't go with the its construction because you already learned about this Zener diode. So if you have any doubt regarding that, just go back to your Zener diode concept, just go through it, how it has a sharp breakdown and how it differs from the normal diode and its characteristics curve, you'll get an idea. Okay, so having the idea of Zener diode, you'll understand voltage regulator using the generator. That means how we can use the generator for the voltage regulation purpose. Okay, let's go with this circuit. This is the circuit of voltage regulation using the generator. In this, we can see we have an input voltage V in here, and we have a current limiting resistor RS in series with the load. Okay, RS is a current limiting resistor, and here we have a zener diode connected in a reverse breakdown region. Okay, and this is the load RL. Now, the function of RS is to limit the excessive current. Okay, so it will limit the excessive current. Now go with this statement given here. The above figure shows the shunt voltage regulating system using zener diode. Why it is called shunt voltage regulating system? Because here zener diode, this main element is connected across or parallel to the load, in shunt with the load. So it is called as a shunt voltage regulating system. Okay, the output voltage is determined by the reverse breakdown voltage of a zener diode. Means this output voltage, this you can see in this equation, Vz equal to V naught. Means what? This V naught is determined by the Vz. So whatever the Vz will be designing here, that will be the output. So output voltage is dependent on the breakdown voltage of the zener diode. The zener diode regulator has a limitation of range. So in a regulator concept, when we were discussing, we understood that the voltage regulation can be possible using the zener diode, transistor, operational amplifier, etc. But in that, zener diode is preferred, but it has a disadvantage of the range, because in this example only, we cannot have the V naught apart from the Vz. Okay, so it has a limitation of the range. Okay, that is a disadvantage of the zener diode, but it is very simple. Okay, so that is why it is most preferred over the other types. Now coming to the operation. Okay, so we will understand the operation of this, how the zener diode will be act as a voltage regulator. So we'll go through it once, then we'll discuss. The source resistance RS is connected in series with the zener diode to limit the flow of current through the diode. As I already told you, so the function of that series resistor is to limit the current. So it will limit the flow of current through the diode. Okay, so that is a function of a RS. It may be asked in your asked as a question, what is the purpose or what is the function of this series resistor? You must remember why it is used. Okay, so coming to the operation, whenever a load is connected in parallel with the zener diode, voltage across the load is same as the zener diode voltage, that is a V naught equal to Vz. However, the source voltage must be greater than the zener voltage. If the source voltage is less than the zener voltage, then zener voltage will simply follow the applied input voltage. Okay, so I hope you understood this statement given here. We'll go back to the circuit and we'll discuss. It says that here the load is connected across the zener diode. So output voltage Vz is similar to your, V naught is similar to your Vz. Okay, but here the input voltage must be greater than the Vz. Let's go with some example. Suppose think it has a 15 volts, and here Vz is of 12 volts. So it is 15, 15, and it is at 12 volts. In this case, it has a reverse breakdown voltage of 12 volts. So output will be available as a 12 volt, even the input is a 15 volt. Let's say if it is designed for, it is a 12 volt zener and the input is 8 volt, means it is less than the zener voltage. In this case, what happens? Are we able to get the 12 volt as we designed? No, because it has a condition that the input voltage must be greater than your zener voltage. In that condition only you can get the fixed voltage. If the input voltage is less than this, you cannot get it, because zener diode just passes the input voltage to the output, because Vz become a V, okay, when it is a less than the Vz. So you must remember, when you are using the zener diode as a voltage regulator, the input must be higher than their breakdown voltage. Okay, this is the operation of a zener diode. So now we are dealing with the line regulation. So we already discussed what you mean by line regulation and load regulation in general, as in the regulator concept. But here we will understand how the zener diode is used as a for the line regulation purpose. Okay, so first we have to understand what you mean by we have to revise what is mean by line regulation. So do you remember what you mean by line regulation? We have discussed in the previous session. Okay. So if you are recalling it, it's very good. If not, just I will revise that things again. So what is mean by line regulation? The line regulation means the output remain constant even the change in the line voltage. Line voltage means input voltage. Even the changes in the input voltage, the output remains constant. That is called as a line regulation. Okay, we'll go through it. Then we'll discuss how this circuit will help us in the line regulation. If the supply voltage Vin increases, so this Vin, if this increases, since the generator is in the breakdown region, generator current IZ increases. So when this increases, what happens? First we'll read out, then we'll discuss. Fine. So generator current IZ increases while the load current IL remain constant. This will increase the value of total current I and maintains the output voltage VL constant irrespective of the changes in the input voltage. Okay. We'll understand what is the meaning of this. Suppose, say example, if the V input is increased, when the input voltage is increased, then what happens? Since the this source resistance has a fixed value, so increasing the input voltage will result in the increase in the this current I. So I is increased. Here you can see the I is current I is split into two currents. One is the IZ, that is the zener current. One more is the IL, load current. As per the KCL also, we can understand I is equal to IZ plus IL because the same current is split into two directions, okay, two ways. So as the input voltage is increased, the current I is increased. Now this will increase the IZ, okay. So whenever I is increased, IZ will increase and it will maintain the IL constant. It will not, as IZ is increased, IL will not be changing. It will remain constant. Since IL is fixed and RL is fixed, the V0 remain constant. So what happened? The input voltage results in input voltage result in this current I. That increase will be resulted in the increase in the IZ and maintaining the load current IL. So by this, the output voltage remains constant. V0 equal to IL into RL. IL also fixed, and even IL also maintained constant. The excess current flows through the IZ. Okay. So by this, the output remains constant even though input is changing. This is called line regulation, and this is the operation of a zener diode for the line regulation purpose. So is it easy? It's very easy to understand. So how it is acting as a line regulation. Okay. So this is a line regulation concept. Next, we have a load regulation. So in the previous session, we discussed about the load regulation. What is load regulation? Okay. Load regulation means the output voltage must constant even though change in the load. Okay. If there is any changes in the output voltage must maintain constant. That is the meaning of load regulation. In this, we will understand how the usage of generator will act as a load regulation. Okay, first we will go through this. If the supply voltage VI is constant, so in the line regulation we discussed that as the VI is changing, how it was maintaining the constant. In this, we are discussing some of the load regulation. So in this, we will understand by keeping the VI constant. Okay, so if the supply voltage VI is constant, but the load resistance RL decreases, here we are changing the load. Okay. So load is decreasing. Let's say example, if it is as a 10 kilo ohm and we are changing it to 10 to 8 kilo ohm. Okay. Just you can go with some example. It will make you easy to understand. Okay. RL decreases. When the RL is decreased, it will result in increase of load current IL. So IL current will increase. The additional load current will come from decrease in zener diode IZ. So as this is increased and it will decrease the IZ. The source current I remain constant. Voltage drop across RS will not change. Consequently, the output voltage remain at a constant value. It means to say that in this load regulation, first we'll understand, we are assuming that the input voltage is fixed. We don't have any changes in the input voltage. Okay. So initially the input voltage is fixed. Based on that, the current I is flowing. That I is split into two ways. That is a IZ and IIL. It's a zener current and this is a load current. Okay. So this is the normal condition. Suppose say load is changing. Okay. If it is decreased, okay, it is reduced. So when it is reduced, automatically the IL will increase. Okay. So when IL is increasing, but this I is constant. Okay. Because this input voltage is not changed, this I is constant. The increase in this load current will result in the reduction in the load zener current. By this, what happens? The voltage across this RS remains same, and that will result in the same voltage, means the output voltage remains the constant. So there is no any changes in the output voltage, and we are not getting any effect of change in the load in the output voltage. This is called load regulation, and it is achieved by using the zener diode. So this is the concept of load regulation using zener diode as a regulator. Okay. So this is the concept. So what are the concepts we discussed in the today's session? First, we understood what is zener diode, means what is the characteristics of the zener diode and how we can use the zener diode as a regulator. Then we discussed about how we can use the zener diode for line regulation purpose and what is its operation. Okay. Then we have discussed about load regulation, how we can use the zener diode for the load regulation purpose and its operation. Okay. So these are the topics covered today. Now we are going to solve some problems based on these. Okay, so now we are discussing problems on the regulator. So I will read out the question, then I'll give some time to think. You think about the solution, then we'll discuss. So first, coming to the question, it is given as, if the DC output voltage is 300 volt with no load attached to power supply, but decreases to 250 volt at full load, find the percentage voltage regulation. So in this, they are saying that first with the no load, what is the output voltage, and with the full load, what is the output voltage? Okay. Then they are asking us to calculate the percentage of voltage regulation. So first you have to think what are the prerequisites required to solve this problem and then how to solve. So think about this. What are the prerequisites required to solve this problem? We'll proceed. So in this, first it is a no load voltage is 300 volt, so it is a VNL, and it's a full load voltage is 250 volt, means VFL. Okay, so prerequisite for solving this problem is load regulation. We have to calculate. The equation is VNL minus VFL divided by VFL into 100%. So what is VNL? No load voltage. Okay, minus VFL means full load voltage divided by full load voltage. So in the problem, they have given the value of VNL and they have given the value of VFL. Just we have to substitute those values in this equation, we'll get the load regulation. Let's solve this. So these are the values given. So what is the value given? VL value given as a 300 volt and VFL value is given as a 250 volt. We know the equation. Load regulation equal VNL minus VFL divided by VFL into 100. So substitute the value. VNL value given as 300 volt minus VFL value is 250 volt divided by VFL value 250 volt. So 300 minus 250 is 50 by 250. Okay, into 100. If you calculate this, we'll get a percentage of voltage regulation equal to 20%. Okay. So this is the solution for this problem. Okay, if you understood this, let's proceed to the next question. So next question given. A power supply has a voltage regulation of 1%. if the no load voltage is 40 volt, then what is the full load voltage? So in the earlier question, it was given the no load voltage and full load voltage and asked to calculate the voltage regulation. But in this case, it is voltage regulation is given and no load voltage is given and asking to calculate the full load voltage. So how to proceed this problem? So what is the prerequisite to solve this problem? To solve this problem also, we have the same prerequisite, that is the equation of voltage regulation. Okay. So once again, for this problem also, we need to remember this equation. Okay. Load regulation equation, that is VNL minus VFL divided by VFL into 100. So here they have given the load regulation and they have given the VNL and they are asking us to calculate the VFL. Let's solve this problem. So coming to the solution, they have given the load voltage regulation equal to 1%, no load voltage is equal to 40 volts, full load voltage is to be calculated. Substitute this value, this is a 1%, VNL is 40 and VFL has to calculate. Simplify this, this VFL into 1, this VFL, 40 minus VFL into 100. So if you simplify this, okay, you will get a VFL as 39.60 volts. Okay. So this is the answer for this question. Okay, let's move on to the next question. So this is the third question. It is given as two power supplies A and B are available in the market. Power supply A has no load and full load voltages of 45 volt and 35 volt respectively, whereas these values are 45 volt and 39 volt for the power supply B. Which is better power supply? So they are giving the practical problem, means in practically we have two power supplies. One is power supply A, one more is power supply B. And power supply A has the no load voltage 45 volts and full load voltage of 35 volts. And power supply B has no load voltage of 45 volt and full load voltage of 39 volt. And now they are asking which one is a better power supply. So how to decide which one is better power supply? What is the prerequisite? And think what are the equations we have to use to solve this problem? Once again, to solve this problem, the prerequisite is, once again, the same problem, same equation, that is a load regulation equal to VNL minus VFL divided by VFL. Okay. We will be using the same equation again and we'll be getting the answer. So first thing, before going to use that equation and solving the problem, we must understand that the power supply which has a lower voltage regulation is a better. Okay. So the question was which power supply is better. So first we should know that the power supply whichever has the lower voltage regulation is a better one. Okay. So first we are how to proceed with the solution. For solving this, first we have to calculate the regulation for power supply A. Then we'll be calculating the voltage regulation for the power supply B. So once we know the voltage regulation of both the power supply A and B, then we'll be comparing the both the power supplies, whichever has the lower voltage regulation, then that will be the better power supply. So first, power supply A, the value given VNL is 45 volt, VFL is 35 volts. Okay. So we'll be calculating the load regulation. So VNL minus VFL divided by VFL, substitute this value, 45 volt, VNL, VFL is 35 volt. 45 minus 35 divided by 35. If you simplify this, you will get a 28.57%. This is the load regulation of power supply A. So what is the next step? Now we have to calculate the load regulation of the power supply B. Then we can compare and decide which one is a better one. Okay. Here we have a power supply B. So in power supply B, they are given the value. No load voltage is 45 volt. Full load voltage is 39 volts. So we have VNL and VFL. We'll have a equation VNL minus VFL divided by VFL. Substitute the value. VNL is given 45 volt. VFL is given 39 volt. Once again, VFL is a 39 volt. If you simplify this, we'll get a 15.38%. So now we got the load regulation of power supply A and B. So what was the power supply A load regulation? It is 28.57. For power supply B, it is a 15.38. Which one is having the lower load regulation? That is power B. So can you decide which one is a better now? So in the first statement only we discussed that the power supply which has the lesser load regulation is a better one. So that means power supply B is a good. Therefore, power supply B is a better than the power supply A. So this is the answer for this problem. Next question is, when the input to a voltage regulator decreases by 5 volt, the output decreases by 0.3 volt. The nominal output voltage is 30 volt. Determine the line regulation. So this is related to the line regulation. So think, what are the data given? So data given is change in input voltage. When the input voltage regulator is decreases by 5 volt, so change in voltage is 5 volt. And output decreases, means change in the output is 0.3 volt, and the nominal output, that is V naught, is given as a 30 volt, and asking us to calculate or determine the line regulation. So what are the prerequisite to solve this problem? To solve this problem, we must know the formula of line regulation, and we must understand what are the given data, then we can substitute the value and calculate the line regulation. So prerequisite is this equation, that is a line regulation equation, that is given as delta V naught by V naught into 100 divided by delta VI. What is delta V naught? It is a change in output voltage. V naught means it's a nominal output voltage. Delta VI means change in input voltage. Okay. So this is the equation. Now let's solve this problem. So given values are change in input voltage is 5 volt, change in output voltage is 0.3 volt, and nominal output voltage V naught is equal to 30 volt. So this is the equation of line regulation, delta V naught by V naught into 100% divided by delta VI. So let's substitute this value in this equation. So delta V naught given as a 0.3. So we wrote it as a 0.3. And divided by V naught is 30, that is a divided by 30 into 100%. Delta V is given is a 5 volt. So if you calculate this, it will turn out to 0.2% by V. Okay, so this is the line regulation value. This is the answer for this problem. So now we'll deal with some question banks. Okay. So we'll read out the question, try to answer this. This circuit is known as, so they are given one circuit and they are given the four options. You have to select the correct one. So they are given the option as a series pass voltage regulator. Is it the series pass voltage regulator? Okay, then next option is a shunt voltage regulator. Third option is a step-up switching regulator. Fourth one, a step-down switching regulator. So they have given the four options. You have to understand and answer which one is the correct one. Which one is the correct answer? So let's discuss the option, then we'll understand which one is the correct answer. So first option says it's a series pass voltage regulator. Series pass voltage regulator is in this main element is Zener diode. is it connected in series with the load? No. So this answer is wrong. It's not the correct answer. Next option is a shunt voltage regulator. So here shunt means it's a parallel. So in this you can observe the active pass element, that Zener diode is connected in shunt with the load. So it might be the correct answer. Let's see the other option as well. The third option is a step up switching regulator. Is it the step up switching regulator? No. Then the one more option is a step down switching regulator. No, it is not a step down switching regulator. So the only correct answer is a shunt voltage regulator. So answer for this question is 1B. This is the correct answer for this question. Next line regulation. Next question is, line regulation can be calculated using the following formula. So they have given the four formulas. Okay, we have to select the correct one. So the first one is delta V naught by V naught into 100% divided by delta VI. Second option, V naught by VI. Third option, delta VI by V naught into 100% divided by delta V naught. Fourth option, delta VI by VI into 100% divided by delta V naught. So which one is the correct answer? So actually the line regulation deals with maintaining the output voltage constant for the change in the input voltage. Means change of the output voltage with respect to change in input voltage deals with that concept. And the correct answer for the line regulation is the first one, option A. That is a change in output voltage with respect to the nominal voltage over the change in the input voltage. So option A is the correct answer for this question. Next, third question. In the case of load regulation, the option given are, when the temperature varies, the output voltage stays constant. This is one option. Second option, when the input voltage changes, the load current stays constant. Then third option, when the load changes, the load current stays constant. Then fourth option, when the load changes, the output voltage stays constant. So they are given the four options. We have to understand which one is the correct one. So read out the options given and try to answer it. So to answer this question, first you must remember or recall what is mean by load regulation. We discussed that load regulation means maintaining the output voltage constant irrespective of the changes in the output load. Okay, so whenever there is a change in the load, it must not affect the output voltage. That is a load regulation. So let's see this option. It deals with the, when the temperature varies, the output voltage stays constant. It dealing with the temperature variation. But actually load regulation deals with the changes in the load value, not the temperature. So this is not the correct answer. Second option says, when the input voltage changes, the load current stays constant. So it's dealing with the input voltage change. So load regulation not deals with this. The line regulation deals with input voltage change. So this is the wrong answer. Third option is, when the load changes, the load current stays constant. So it's dealing over the load changes, fine. But it says that load current stays constant. Are you dealing with the current of the load? No. Load regulation means it deals with the maintaining the output voltage. That is, the load voltage must be constant. So this is also not a correct answer. The last option is, when the load changes, the output voltage stays constant. It means, so whenever the load changes, the output voltage stays constant. That is the correct answer for load regulation. So option 3D is a correct answer. Next, fourth question is, in the case of line regulation, when the temperature varies, the output voltage stays constant. It's the first option. when the output voltage changes, the load current stays constant. It's the second option. Third option, when the input voltage changes, the output voltage stays constant. So third option. Fourth one is, when the load changes, the output voltage stays constant. So they have given the four statements for the line regulation, and you have to choose the correct answer. Okay. So understand the correct answer. First, we should remember the concept of line regulation. Line regulation says that whenever there is a change in the input voltage or the supply voltage, output voltage remains constant. That is the concept of line regulation. Let's deal with one by one option. First option says that when the temperature varies, the output voltage stays constant. So it's dealing with the temperature variation. So actually, line regulation will not deal with the temperature variation. So it's a wrong answer. When the output voltage changes, the load current stays constant. It's dealing with the load current and output voltage, and it's not dealing with the supply voltage variation. So it is also not a correct answer. Third option is, when the input voltage changes, the output voltage stays constant. So it's dealing with the input voltage and saying about the output voltage maintaining constant. So this is the correct answer. Okay. And let's see the fourth option. When the load changes, the output voltage stays constant. So dealing with the load, the line regulation will not deal with the load changes. It's only deal with the input voltage change. So the correct answer for this question is 4C. Okay. So this is the correct answer. Let's see the one more question. The main purpose of the current limiting resistor in the regulator circuit. So what is the main function of current limiting resistor? So in this session, in the beginning, we had a series resistor RS, and we have discussed what is the purpose of current limiting resistor. The option given is protection of the regulator from the excessive current, protection of the load from the excessive current, to keep the power supply transformer from burning up, fourth option, to maintain the constant output voltage. These are the four options given. So which one is the correct answer? So the correct answer for this question is protection of the regulator from the excessive current. Whenever there is excessive current, it will be drawn by the or it will be limited by the current limiting resistor. So that is the purpose of using the current limiting resistor. So answer is 5A. So this is the answer for fifth question. Okay. So these are the questions we have discussed on this session. Okay. So I hope everyone understood this topic very well. Okay. So go through this again. If you have any doubts, you can go through the session again. You will get the answer for all your doubts. Okay. Thank you.